are in levels. The most expensive one is hearing audibly. But tell me, let me church, I'm here to tell you, forget about that one. You don't need it. You know why I say? Because many people in their life, they have been praying. All they want is to hear from God audibly. You're wasting your time. Doesn't, because that one has substitute. What is the substitute? Prayer. How do you know that you have heard from God? When something supernatural happens. When you pray, what happens? Supernatural things happen to you. I was going to Malaysia and it was raining in my head. Idika. So you are opening your eyes to go and destroy your whole family in Malaysia. I was hearing it clear. I didn't tell any of them. No mind. But you know what I said in my heart? I said, God, I can never worship a God. I can never serve a God that lies. That is always lying. You say, when God is for you, who can be against you? I am 100% sure. I'm only hearing in my mind. I have never, in the dream, the way you speak to me through dreams. All the dreams I had, positive. Paul said, within we are fearing, and without we are fighting. And a lot of things started happening. Somebody was there threatening, I will destroy you, I will do that. I said, that's the devil. Pepper tiger. I said, God, I can't. I'm above that level. One, I can't just ordinary. Even when I was living, I don't know how to lie. Because people that lie are afraid of people. It is fear that makes you laugh. I'm not afraid of anybody. I wasn't afraid when I was an unbeliever. I was a very hard man. Police cannot come to arrest me and I will run away. I don't run away from police. I cannot be doing something and you call police for me and I will run away because of police. I was that kind of person. I wasn't afraid of fighting, anything. Now that I have known this God that is most powerful, when I was in the dark world, I wasn't afraid of anything. Now that I'm in the light with the God that is most powerful, and somebody is saying he's going to kill me, I say, God, let me go and see how weak you are. Where have I wronged you? You told me to leave Nigeria and come to Australia. On the way, you didn't tell me about Malaysia. I entered Malaysia, finished Malaysia, now I'm in Australia. Where have I failed you? I've not been here. My family has not gone to holiday for 6 years. And now that you provide, we pray for this holiday. It was you that provided the money. This I'm telling you is the truth. One, that I may know thee. I don't want to serve a God that I will not be improving on knowing me. Because you can never understand God. But I have to try as much as I can to gather the little I have. I said, God, I can't. Let my children die. If they die, okay. They'll go to hell if heaven is free. Paul cannot be 100% sure and be telling you that I may know thee. He still has some doubt. He still needed some clarification. Even in his level. That was what I did with my trip to Malaysia. I said, let me go and see. I started prayer. I didn't need to hear from God. I started prayer. Prayer. Karam. There was a day I woke up 1 o'clock. I prayed to 6 o'clock. Because of my trip to Malaysia. Chicago, Skebrem Kukuya, Kanda Brakatoya, Kenya. God, show me how weak or how strong you are with this strength. And you know, when that guy that was ranting, shouting, making noise, anytime he speak, I would tell them, watch out this guy, he can't come near me. If he come near me, he will be destroyed. But he was ranting, he was saying he would do anything, he would do all this thing. But I've already prayed. And I know if I touch him, he will die. I said, no, this guy that he shouted everywhere, he's not going to do anything. While we are there, what? You know, when there's something about when somebody that doesn't talk, and somebody that is not seeing, when he sees. I was at the airport as we were about to board. Somebody that doesn't talk, I knew he would not He knows me very well. He sent me SMS. You don't understand what I mean. That kind of person can never tell you such thing. And he sent me SMS and said, be careful with the Malaysia. At the airport, as I was boarding, send me a set SMS. I didn't show it to anybody. I said, God, this person is somebody, if you say be careful, I know there is danger. You can be careful with this Malaysia you're going. The guy is in America. He doesn't know anything. But he just sent me SMS and said, be careful with Malaysia you're going. I saw the SMS, I deleted it. Are you getting what I'm saying now? I wasn't saying, God, tell me, I have already prayed. Because with prayer, you don't need that here. Are you getting my point? So that you don't go searching, using your computer everywhere. Where will I hear blood? Where will I? You're wasting your time. Jesus taught us the substitute. As it was his custom, every morning he will go to a solitary place. He will pray and demand from heaven what is his focus. And God will reveal it to him. Now there's another one, which is the fastest way of hearing from God. But we don't take it. We don't appreciate it. We appreciate the one that they deceive us. Holy Ghost say. Holy Ghost say. Holy Ghost say. Please, it's not easy. It's not. You will still make that mistake. But be conscious of it that there's nothing like Holy Ghost say. Holy Ghost say. It's better you tell the person that you're talking to, I see you. And if you are convinced, it's what you are getting in your spirit. Because it's no more you, it's the Spirit of God. And now you see, he will speak through your mouth. But you can hear from God. But I'm here to tell you, you don't need to start fighting to hear from God. Because whatever you want to hear from God is already in your hand. Let's go to James. Let me show you what I mean. James chapter 1. Start from verse 21. Yes.
Wherefore, lay apart all filthiness and superficiality of naughtiness.
Now listen, lay apart what?
All filthiness.
All filthiness. Clean yourself, be clean. That's what the Bible says. Be clean, number one. Be clean. Now, we are going also the process of hearing from God. This is the simplest way and the easiest way to hear from God. You don't need that one. You can't be able to sustain hearing, Paul, why are they persecuting me? You can't. Deep calling for him. Don't wait for that time because you don't even need it. He said, be clean, number one. Number two, what? Look at number two, I'll explain it.
And superficiality.
Stop being a hypocrite. Don't say something and go. Don't be cosmetic. You know, when you use cosmetics, what happens? If you are black before, you become brown. Or you become, I don't know what to call that one. Chicken color. You know? In Africa, we call them Phantom Coke. Phantom Coke, you see, black and white in the same body. That's cosmetic, that's superficial. You are not rooted. You are just on top. These are the processes giving us the key. If you want to hear this word, be clean. Two, stop being superficial. Continue.
And receive with meekness and the grafted word.
You see, when you are being taught the word, do you know what is meekness? Do you know what is meekness? Good, that's good, but I'll give you 20%. What is meekness?
Opinion wise, but not.
Hmm?
Thinking wise, but not.
What is meekness? Meekness, you have all the power to do what you need to do. You have all the power to do what you do, but when you are advised, when you are told to do something, you forget your power and do that. You know, somebody you are stronger, better than. Listen, as your pastor, if Marvin come now and say, and I know it's God saying, Marvin now come and say, don't drive that red car there. Give it to me. You are now my God. Are you hearing me? That's meekness. If I follow him because I know it's God speaking, that's meekness. So two people that the Bible used meekness to describe, who were they?
Moses
and who? Jesus. So power under control. Having all the power. But when you are spoken to, when you are insulted, when everything, you just laugh. That's meekness. So what does that mean? What in this context of the Bible, what is he saying? He's saying you can never, ever, ever hear God through his word if you are not meek. What does that mean? You have all the knowledge. You have your computer. You have PhD, permanent head damage. You have everything. But you say, humble yourself, behave as if you have never learned anything. You don't even know anything as you hear the word of God. He listened to it with meekness. Can you read? Does that make sense? Read it again.
Wherefore lay apart all filthiness and superficiality or naughtiness and receive with meekness.
And receive with meekness. He's saying meekness, saying you are a wise person. You have knowledge. You are strong. You know you are a philosopher. You are a PhD holder. He said, but throw away all those things as you hear the word of God now. Do not ever use your philosophical understanding. Do not use your intellectual understanding. Do not use your, education background to weigh what I'm saying. And that is the problem we are having. That is why we have people writing a lot of books, telling you the Bible, preachers making a lot of, telling in Bible school, they are turning everything upside down. Because they add their feeling. Oh, the person I'm preaching to now, repent, if you don't repent, you go to hell. Hell? Hell? No, don't be afraid. America said, any message that will make anybody feel guilty is not from God. Any message, what a lie. Any message that will make somebody feel guilty is not from God. That's what American preachers preach. Any message that will make somebody feel guilty, and the person will say, oh, I have to repent. Say, it's not from God. Why? They are weighing feeling. They want to, now, the kind of message that they say that is from God is preaching, pastor, motivational preaching. You know, preaching, oh, I love it, man, speak to me. But the one that will say, no, I have missed it. I thought I was on the wrong right side. I never knew I was on the wrong side. So this was heavy mistake. Holy Ghost, forgive me. He said, it's not for you. That's what they're saying indirectly. What is conviction? The Bible says, Holy Ghost will convince us and convict. Church, am I making sense? Are you getting what I'm saying? So they are adding human rights to the preaching of the gospel. Human rights. Do you know what human rights, the final explanation of human rights? Whatever that is right in your ears, in your eyes is right. And what was the major sin of Israel? The Bible says, when those that were with Moses or with Joshua, when they all died, the people started doing what was right in their own eyes. And anytime they do that, what happened? God will send the Midianite. God will send them. Allow their enemies to toil with them. So we are here now.
21.
Yes. No, you've read 21. Say, receive the word of God, because that's another way. Continue. 22.
Okay. But be doers of the word.
Do you not see now? Continue.
And not hearers only.
Please, church, I want to ask a question. Hearing from God that we are talking about, is it the same with the one this one is talking about? It is. You see, because you hear from God, you don't hear it from the thundering star. Me thundering, you know? That's my own English. From thunder, I got it from thunder. Because you're not hearing from thundering side, thundering, if it is my twin, they will say thundering. Because you don't hear it from like thunder, you don't have respect for it. It's the same word you want to hear, it's the same with this. But it's just that one, you have to be clean. Two, stop being a hypocrite. Three, though you know everything, though you are wise, when you hear it, never you weigh it, only weigh it, because it's not by mind, not by power, but by the spirit of the living God. Only weigh it with what the spirit is saying, not with what your knowledge is saying. Continue. Say, do not be only hearers. So what does that mean, church? Many people hear from God. That's what we are going to deal with this afternoon. They hear, but yet they don't do it. Continue.
Deceiving your own self.
Deceiving your own self.
For if any be a hearer of the word, and not a doer, he is like unto a man beholding his natural face in a glass.
Yeah, in the mirror.
For he beholding himself.
He sees his face as if he has pointed nose.
And going his way.
But when he leaves that mirror,
and straight away
he will forget how he looks.
Forgetting what manner of man he was.
Does that make sense? He said, if you are a hearer and you're not a doer, you don't understand. Most of you, all of you here, my children, most of you here, we are born here. I mean, somebody has paid the price for you to be in Australia. You don't know what it means to catch up to be a citizen of Australia. You don't know the price. You don't know. Your parents paid the price for you. You don't know what it means. So you will always play with it. It doesn't have value to you. I look at my children. I look at them. I say, God, you are fair, very fair. There's no ways. There are things that I know. Haven't been the one from Nigeria to here. It will be hard for them unless I start taking them. Imagine them. If they go to Nigeria now and see Buhari, prevailing of Nigeria, they will fail. Imagine they will fail. Because they have never seen any human being like that. Only seen our president Buhari. Or now hear about Boko Haram. Or hear about Fulani herdsmen using knives to cut people anyhow. Actually, I've not seen that kind of brutality before. But we're seeing it. When we were here, if somebody steal in Africa, you see people, they gather in the market, use knife, cut the person, get tied, put and burn the person. Does it happen in your place? When you were, this man put his head here, you see, I've seen something like that. Look at this. Agriculture human being. Mama, you used to see it in Africa. When somebody steals, you do it in Liberia?
Yeah.
When they steal, they burn them. They kill them there in the street.
Yeah.
I would say, really? They don't say such thing. If you go there now and see, you start shouting, I want Panadol. Take me to women and children. Church of God in Malaysia. 2011. I went with an Australian. Listen, you know, that Australian has never traveled. That Australian, as I said, was 47 years old. She has never traveled out of Australia since she was born. Do you know what happened? Immediately we got to Malaysia. We drove her to her hotel room. And the next day, we were hot time. The next day, she said, I want to look around. Hear this thing I'm telling you. Immediately she saw the way Malaysians were riding their car. Vam, vam, vam. No control like Australia. Nothing. Did you start shaking? Start shaking. I said, what is the problem? You said, what is happening here? Where are we? Am I there? I said, no, you're not there. Am I in hellfire? I said, no, you're not in hellfire. He said, I've never seen such people. She entered into shock. Do you know we have to change our ticket to take her back to Australia? We have to. She can't stay here. Her brain cannot be able to calculate. Cannot be able. He said, be not ye here. I want you to continue your way with that person.
For if any be a hearer of the word,
yes,
and not a doer,
not a doer.
But whoso looketh into the perfect law of liberty.
If you look at the word of God, if you hear from God through his word, that's what he's saying. So you can hear from God the same way.